Once a major crop in the Old Dominion, wheat is now grown on about 1,000 farms across the state. Industry leaders hope to see more wheat raised here to provide local grain supplies to two major grain mills in Culpeper and Roanoke.
Virginia wheat is definitely our favorite wheat to work with. 100% of all of our soft wheat that we grind here is from Virginia, sourced locally. And then our hard wheat, we end up sourcing less than 2% from Virginia. So that's really the big opportunity that we're looking for, is to source more of our hard wheat from local farmers in this area.
Like many American farmers, Virginia wheat growers prefer to plant wheat in the fall, let it go dormant in the winter, and harvest it in the early summer. It's better timing for their crop rotations and spreads out their machinery use. But wheat is a finicky crop that requires a lot of attention. Alan Welch of Northumberland County has been raising it for years and has won awards for his quality and yields. He says getting a good start in the fall is key to success.
We usually get the seed in here sometime in August. We pick our varieties that we're going to plant, and we put them in here in August. Then we'll start prepping the land up as soon as the corn crop's off. We'll start running a turbo till or a disc over it to try to get rid of the organic matter from the corn crop. And then along in the middle of October, we'll start putting down the wheat seed and then working it in.
When the wheat crop goes dormant, growers like Welch and his son Justin move on to other projects over the winter. But once the weather warms up again, they have to focus on crop fertilization and keeping it free of pests and diseases. Virginia wheat farmers can earn top dollar for good, clean wheat delivered to the mill. The best growers know what it takes to raise a good crop, and buyers value that expertise.
Well, the local growers will come in here, they'll weigh in their truck, we'll use our automatic probe to probe samples from different spots in their truck, and then send it to our quality lab, where our techs there will run and analyze the properties of that wheat, and they'll get immediate feedback on what parameters their wheat has, and they'll know approximately what we're paying, what types of premiums we're paying for those parameters.
Millers face their own technical challenges in grinding wheat kernels to the exact flour specifications needed by commercial baking companies. It's a far cry from the pioneer days of a single set of grinding stones and some flour sacks.
Basically, we're taking the wheat in here, we're blending it over here, you know, for the first blend, and then we're sending it over to the mill. The milling unit, we have just one large milling unit, but that has several roll stands, which are corrugated rolls that are really just grinding, rolling in on each other, and we have the stream of wheat passing right in between those rolls. So once the wheat is cracked open, we're sending that up to some sifters and purifiers. So sifters will basically gravity feed the different particulate of the wheat kernel through different openings and different screen sizes so that we can separate different fractions into different areas. And then our purifiers will help to use air to separate the flour particles by different densities.
Virginia soft wheat flour is used in recipes for crackers and cookies instead of bread. But the staff at Ardent Mills and Roanoke's Mental Milling Company grind the flour to make millions of those treats every year.
And then it just kind of cycles through, continually hitting those roll stands and then sifting and then purifying until we've got a final product that we can send to our storage bins. And then we'll pull out of those storage bins and send them through our final product zone to make sure that there's no metal, no other contaminants. And then that'll go straight into a tanker at our facility here. Our main mode of shipping is 50,000 pound tankers. And that's how we distribute to all of our bakeries that we service.
These wheat mills are major manufacturing operations that have invested millions of dollars in major storage facilities and modern milling equipment. But most of their hard winter wheat comes by rail from the Midwest and Canada. So they'd love to see more local growers develop the skills to raise good quality wheat.
That with the end goal really to be that we would build a source, a very large percent of our hard wheat, of our hard winter wheat from Virginia. You know, it's a win-win for both of us because, you know, the farmer makes more money and we're able to, you know, save on transportation costs and, you know, have a reliable source right at our doorstep.
It can take years for younger farmers to become experts in raising a good wheat crop. and a couple of days of rain in the spring can turn a good crop into animal feed instead of flour. But the opportunities are there for those who are interested and are looking for a way to stay in the family business.
Some farms, you know, grow wheat for cash crop. That's primarily what we grow it for, is a cash crop in the summertime. Some farms don't have that need. It's pretty much on the individual farmer's idea basis what they want to do as far as growing wheat. As far as seeing more of it grown, it's a beautiful crop to, you know, watch it come up and watch it, you know, grow.
Thinking of my grandfather, all the, you know, I'm farming the same fields he farmed for many years, and he's no longer with us, but, it, you know, every once in a while you think about him and you, you know, the hard work he put into it, and just want to continue that hard work and make him proud and make my father proud, and just carry on the name and the business.
In Northumberland County, Virginia, I'm Ricky Gibson reporting.